back once again for the Olympus Stylus TG3, a little bit more in-depth review, closer look. Here's the front of the camera itself. On the right-hand end, we have the loop for the waterproof float or your wrist strap or whatever accessory you decide to attach. On the back, we have the nice large screen, the mode setting dial, the info button, the playback button, the button to select exposure, flash, and time delay, and also the menu button. On the left end, we have the door for the HDMI output port and the battery charge port. These doors have both a lock and a release to open. And there's your two ports. And lock and lock. Okay. On the bottom, you have your door for your memory card and your battery. Again, unlock and release. Door simply swings open. Battery releases with a simple pull tab. And memory card, as in most, is a spring-loaded affair. Pull it out. And notch goes to the right in this case. Shut the door, latch it, and lock it. Okay. On top, we have our GPS antenna, Wi-Fi antenna, the stereo microphones. We have the power on-off button here, the shutter release button here, and the wide and telephoto lever here. Okay. So let's hit the on-off button, power the camera up. And currently we are in program mode. Okay. And first thing I'd like to do is just walk through the menu selections right here. So let's start working our way down the menus. We have at the top Wi-Fi start. And you select by hitting the OK button. And if you want to tie this into your smartphone using Wi-Fi, you can. To go back, you simply hit the menu button to previous selection. Reset initializes your settings related to shooting. I assume sets everything back to factory default. Compression, you have a selection of fine or normal. Image quality. Normal, of course, will give you more images. In this case, with a 32 gig card, that's 7907. Selecting fine will give us 3656. I'm going to go for the fine. Shadow adjust. You can have that set for automatically to brighten shaded areas, or you can turn it on and off and leave it on auto. Autofocus mode. Face ESP, use face detection, focus within the middle of the frame for spot, and keep focusing on the subject with autofocus tracking. Leave that on face. ESP mode sets the metering method, which is basically the full screen, or you can use pretty much what you call spot metering in the center. Digital zoom on off, that's pretty much personal preference. I like to leave it on. Don't always use it, but it's nice to have it at the ready if you do. Next is image stabilizer. On, off, pretty self-explanatory. Accessory settings, remote flash or conversion lens. Don't have either one of those. Autofocus illumination. turn the lamp on and off during low light autofocus, view of your image after you shoot. You can select the time there. Picture orientation changes the orientation of the playback image. Date stamp on off. I'll leave that off. Super res zoom. Turn that on and off. Supposedly, if you go into an extended zoom, you don't lose image quality. So have to see how that works. Next is image size for movie mode. Here are your choices: 1080p, 720, VGA. You can do 120 or 240 high speed, which effectively give you slow-mo. Leave it on 1080. Image stabilization in movie mode, microphone, wind noise setting, on or off. I'll leave that off. Recording volume level. Okay. Oops. Oh, to jump to a menu, you can go to the left here by hitting the left-hand side of your ring. And let's go back to our next one, which is playback menu. Okay. So slideshow plays back images by frame. You can edit an image, erase an image, set up print order, protect an image, or share an image. Okay. Next is format your memory card, backup your image data to a memory card. You also have an iFi setting. If you have an iFi card, which is basically a Wi-Fi memory card, custom mode setup, where you can save your current shooting settings for quick access in the future. USB connection, you can set it up for, set your camera up as a PC card reader, as a card reader, as a portable device, or as a PIC bridge, connect to a PIC bridge compatible printer. Set it up for storage. Power on, allow you to play back even while the power is off. And sound settings for your various functions. Okay. And next is pixel mapping. This is done at the factory. It recommends you do this after a year of ownership. And it's spelled out in the manual. Monitor brightness, TV output format, NTSC, HDMI out, and HDMI control. Language selection. World time, set to an alternate time zone if you'd like. Tough settings, here you can set turn the internal manometer on to give you altitude and depth readings, set it for meters or feet. Tap control, which allows you to control various camera functions by tapping on the camera itself, and the LED illuminator that you can use for various functions as well, particularly like macro photos. Okay. And next we have GPS settings. Turn the GPS off for now to save the battery. Auto time adjust by way of the GPS, and set up for track mode. And you can get, I think it's appended GPS data to give you the most up-to-date information possible. Next up, we have Wi-Fi settings to set up to your home Wi-Fi or someone else's connection password. Reset Wi-Fi settings. Interval settings. This is for time-lapse type photography. You can do up to 99 frames. You can set your start waiting time, how long you want to wait before you actually start the sequence, the interval time. Both these are between 0 and 24 hours, I believe. And you can set this up to record a time-lapse movie create a time-lapse movie from your still pictures. Pretty cool. Focus bracket setting, number of pictures that you want to take as part of your photo focus bracketing, 10, 20, or 30, and focus range, narrow, normal, and wide. Certification, device certification. We're certified. Okay, that completes the menus. Let's begin to look at some of our other features and functions. Here is your video record button, right here above your function selector dial. Just get power back up. And you have your information button, which gives you your histogram display. Drew a blank there for a moment. And also, if you have your GPS turned on, it'll give you your latitude, longitude, altitude, water depth, time, date, compass. Standard display shows special features enabled, flash mode, exposure mode, white balance, ISO setting, and you basically toggle through those like this. Time delay on shutter. Resolution mode, format, flash mode, etc. Okay. And then you have your function display wheel, program mode, custom mode for your preset custom settings, photo story mode, which you can combine several images together. Nice feature. Art mode, which gives you various functions. You have Art 1, which is pop art, soft focus, pale and light colors, grainy film effect, pinhole camera effect, diorama effect, dramatic. That's pretty cool. Okay, and if you want to use that. And then you go to fully automatic mode, or excuse me, aperture mode, where you can manually set your aperture down here at the bottom. And you go up or down with that. Of course, your shutter speed will change. There is no time value mode. Only aperture. Okay, and you got scene mode, which gives you quite a few options. You got portrait, smooth portrait, basically, landscape, interval shooting, time lapse, handheld starlight, night scene, night portraits, sports, indoors, self portraits, sunsets, fireworks, cuisine, documents, beach and snow, snapshots near the water or in the water, underwater landscape, underwater action, macro mode, underwater, snow mode, panorama, backlight HDR to give you high dynamic range, and back to portrait mode. So quite a few selections there in the scene setting. And you have microscope mode to get you really, really close. But basically, I've taken some test shots, which I will include in the video, to get you really close. And basically, it'll give you, you've got microscope, you've got focus stacking to give you an extended depth of field, focus bracketing, super close-ups with magnification. So that's a pretty cool setup you got there. full auto, of course, where basically the camera's doing everything. Very limited selections that you have here. You can adjust the flash and your self timer and your pixel count, and your format, but that's about it. Okay, so, and then back to program again. So that's the function select. All right. And I believe that pretty much covers the Olympus TG3. Let's power off. And hope this has been informative and helpful to some of you out there. Thanks for watching.